What's up, San Diego? It is December 26, 2019, Boxing Day in some parts of the world. A lot has happened on the campaign trail leading up to the day past Christmas. I'm going to update you, so let's do this. So my goddaughter from Austria sent me a package, and that's really sweet of her. It's nice to be loved, right? So she sent me some tea. This is from Austria. Some nice tea. Some milk chocolate. Milch Hasenuf. Hasenuf. Yeah, I haven't been practicing German for a while. And some famous Austrian chocolate here. Oh yeah, Salzburg chocolate, I love it. Mozart's pictures on that, I don't know if you can see that or not. A nice little card here, that was very sweet of her, I love it. So a lot has been going on, most notably a couple of forums took place that I wasn't invited to. I'm not the only guy, but I mean there's 16 to 26 candidates in this race. And a couple of forums took place where there were only six in one, three in another, and then five or six in another that I wasn't invited to. Now, I don't know if that's an oversight or if the groups putting on these forums just feel that certain people are viable candidates based upon past political experience or the amount of money that they are putting into their campaign or the amount of people donating to their campaign. I don't know. But if this is a true democracy, all candidates should be invited to all forums so that the people can make an informed decision on who they would like to represent them. We shouldn't be dictated to on who certain people feel viable candidates are or are not. Now, it's okay for someone or a group to endorse a candidate. That's fine. But make your endorsement based upon all available information. If you're not talking to all the candidates, this is not a true democracy. And this is what's fundamentally wrong with our system here. It's supposed to be a government for the people, by the people, and all that. But really, it's for whoever has the most amount of money and can get their name out there. And that's just wrong. So, yeah. I'm not going to name which candidates went to which forums and which people put on said forms, but you can look that up. I'm not throwing stones, I'm just making a point that the people should be allowed to choose their own representative and shouldn't be told who they should be choosing among. Like, if there's 26 people in a race, let them hear all 26 people. If there's three, let them hear three. Simple as that. So beyond that, my campaign is starting to move forward. I had a Christmas party on the 15th, invited a bunch of people over, musicians, supporters, potential supporters, and it was a lot of fun. It was from 2 in the afternoon till 10 at night, and a lot of people came through. I mean, I estimated like 60, but then I talked to this one woman who was there. She said, no, it was more like 200 people. What are you talking about? 200 to 300. And yeah, a lot of, there were waves, you know. It started off slow and then all of a sudden swelled up and there were people in every room and digging the music and talking and drinking and having food and just getting to know one another and asking me questions. Of course, I made small campaign speeches throughout the event, just letting them know that I was running in case there were people there that didn't know me. And this house party thing I do, this music thing I do is really, so this music thing I do is really to bring the community together. When I purchased this house in Bankers Hill, the moment I walked in there, it just took my breath away because I realized the potential that this house had to bring people together. I literally said, and there was a friend with me that day, I said, oh my goodness, I should buy this house and I can have all these events here and people could come and meet and da-da. And that's really, it wasn't about showing off the house or buying a big home. I'm one person. This house has five bedrooms. but it's really neat. It's an old craftsman style home in Bankers Hill. It has a lot of character, and it has brought a lot of people together. A lot. And I'm thankful for that. So, the reason I had this event was, again, celebrate the holidays, bring people together, let them know I'm running for Congress. Hopefully they will spread the word around, emphasizing I'm running a no money campaign, which, and all people there wanted to like donate to me. And I go, no, no money. I really don't want your money. I mean, I don't know any other job in the United States where someone asks you for money so they can get employed by someone else and then say thank you. I don't get it. So I feel elections should be publicly funded. I don't know what that looks like, but I'm sure there's smarter people out there than I am that could figure it out. But when a candidate could spend up to $1 million to run for a seat that pays $174,000, I think there's something wrong with the system. It makes no sense to me, and it's not their money. So I think we need to change it. Also, as I mentioned earlier, with the forums that took place and only a few candidates were invited, I mean, maybe there's somebody in the community, you know, like Joe the plumber type of guy who really wants to run for Congress and represent his or her community, but they can't because they don't have money to get their name out there. That's wrong. And maybe they would be the best representative this district or any district ever had if they were just given the opportunity. Same thing with education. There's kids out there now that probably hold the key to cancer in their brain, but because they're not being allowed to be educated because of the lack of funds, society loses. Society wins if everyone's educated and informed and practicing critical thinking skills. That's what's lacking. And I think the system, to some part, doesn't want a educated electorate, because then you would actually research the ballot initiatives, research the candidates or history, as opposed to just, oh, there's so much here, I'll just pick one, or I know this guy's name or that guy's name or whatever. We really need to stay engaged in the process. So as a representative, after I win this election, part of my initiative is to keep the community engaged. It's not like John Brooks wins the election and then, okay, John takes care of it, we go back to our life. No, this is your life. You need to stay engaged in the process. I will be giving you weekly updates on what occurred on the Hill, who came in and talked to me, who talked to my staff, what they wanted. Any bills coming up, I'll let you know about it. I'll say, hey, this bill is coming up for a vote. This is what's in it. This is what I think we should do. What do you guys think? Because I'm representing you. I'm not dictating to you. Now I'll give you my position because I'm a member of the community as well. So what it comes down to is what the community wants, not what I want. I am your representative, just representing the community, that's it. So what else can I tell you? I'm going to redo my website, so look for some changes on that. I'm going to be included in a few forms. I'll put that down on there so you can see if you want to come and check it out. Hear what I have to say, hear what the other people have to say, and you make your informed decision based upon what you hear. Or ask for more information. Putting up videos daily, please look at that. Some of the people in the community have given me their endorsement. A lot of them were at my party, so you might want to check that out. I'll be walking the district, talking to people, talking to small businesses, and really gearing up for the March 3rd primary. So I hope you're with me. I hope you vote. If you're not registered to vote, take a look at this link that I'm providing for you. Any questions, please email me. Drop me a line on social media, johnbrooksforcongress.com or at johnbrooksforcongress. Or if you do Twitter, it's 2020 John Brooks. So that's it. I hope you're all having a great Boxing Day. If you're back at work, enjoy that as well. Whatever you do, do it well. So, take care. Until next time, cheers.